Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I'm Jordan, and today I'm doing a redo because I left my microphone off the entire time without realizing it. I don't usually edit my videos. I just, you know, talk and then put them up. But anyways, this video is about Sacha Baron Cohen and his little speech at the ADL. Someone wants censorship. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. Actually, if I got to say this part, I might have just left the video as it was. Please support Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. Click that link. Read the story. Check out the other donations. And make a donation yourself. None of the money goes to us. It goes to charity. It helps out one of our subscribers and his wife. So please, if you have money laying around and you want to donate it to charity, go to Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. All right. So here we have Sacha Baron Cohen. Since I already did a video on this, since I'm redoing a video, this will probably breeze by a lot faster if I remember all my points. He's basically going to make a case for. I don't know if he explicitly says the government, but. He's basically advocating for some sort of legislative body to come in and regulate your internet to where, and it's based strictly based on hate speech and conspiracy theories. That's right. The dangers of climate change denial. He's one of those pussies. So let's get right to it. Here we go. I just picked a random spot. Let's start there.
And I'm talking about this today because I believe that our pluralistic democracies
yes,
are on a precipice. And then the next 12 months and the role of social media could be determinant. Now, British voters will go to the polls while online conspiracists promote the despicable theory of the Great Replacement, that white Christians are being deliberately replaced by Muslim immigrants. Americans will vote for president while trolls and bots perpetuate the disgusting lie of a Hispanic invasion. And after years of YouTube.
Now, this is why I call this a self-fulfilling prophecy. Well, part of the reason. It's like, banning these guys are going to make them think that even more, is it not? Thus, you're sort of creating the boogeyman you're afraid of. Because they're not allowed, like, don't you want people to freely express their stupid ideas and then they get shut down, you know, by someone smarter than them in response? This happens all, like, if you went to my live channel, I'll have moderators, but I'd tell them, like, you're not allowed to be a moderator if you ban anyone. Like, straight up, no banning. Unless they're, you know, stupid, repeating. Like, someone who just doesn't have a point, there's like, nigger, 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 nigger. Like, all right, you can ban them because they're polluting the chat room and they're taking up space and you can't. I want to get to the real comments, real arguments. So if they say something like, niggers are inherently dumb, they inherently have low IQs. If they said something like that, I'd be like, don't ban him. He has an idea. He has a point. And it's like, oh, I want to conversate. Smack their idea around, and then, like, oh, okay. You got to test your shitty idea against other ideas. It's like, oh, and everyone's basically in agreement that your idea sucks, dude. So maybe you should work on that. And hopefully, if they're an honest person and they're really looking at these ideas seriously, they'll, at some point, maybe I was full of shit, or I was conditioned into this idea, or whatever it is. I went down the wrong rabbit hole. There is no wrong rabbit holes, by the way. You need to be able, when you're trying to find ideas, you should be able to, there should be room for, like, bad ideas, like, to observe them, not to act on them. Guys, like, what this guy's talking about will increase the chances of people acting on the bad ideas rather than, you know, letting them swim around like, okay, what is this thing? I'm really play with this idea and then figuring it out. But let's continue.
YouTube videos calling climate change a hoax, the United States is on track a year from now to formally withdraw from the Paris Accords. A sewer of bigotry and vile conspiracy theories that threaten our democracy and to some degree our planet.
Okay, so with the climate change thing, it's like, do they need to believe in climate change in order to try to make the planet a better place? Is like environmentally, right? Climate change isn't the standard. It doesn't have to be the standard of whether or not I take care of the planet, right? It could be straight up for just normal aesthetic purposes. But hey, it looks better without this trash around. So hey, people die from toxic waste. Or hey, man, I don't want to breathe in that smoke. Even though I won't kill the planet, it still like sucks to have around. I don't want that around. So hey, man, I want to preserve the wildlife. So hey, man, I want these areas untouched by like industrial buildings and all that shit. Let this just be forest. Do I need to believe in climate change for that to for me to think that? No, I don't. So, and then also the second case, obviously, if someone's using a bad idea, not saying climate change denial is a bad idea, I'm saying it's like, oh, they need room to play with the idea first. Hear the idea against other ideas. Then, you know, maybe come to a conclusion someday. Hopefully everyone is taking the stance of, oh, I don't really know, but it seems like this is the case, or something like that. And be like, I will listen to new evidence anytime, no matter what area it comes from. This should be obvious to you guys.
This can't possibly be what the creators of the internet had in mind. I believe that it's time for a fundamental rethink of social media and how it spreads hate, conspiracies, and lies.
Yep. As I said in my other video that was completely on mute the whole time, I said, this guy must feel really good saying this. And I brought up basically like people on Twitter when they say really stupid shit, but it's like, they're like, hey, Clinton would have won if it wasn't for the Russians. I win. It's like, oh, I probably felt really good to type that. Like, it's like, yeah, I feel like you get a warm, fuzzy feeling saying that out loud or, you know, in text form or whatever. It's like, that probably feels really good to say, but it says nothing about whether you're correct or not. It says nothing. Let's continue.
Now, last month, however, Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook delivered a major speech that, not surprisingly, warned against new laws and regulations on companies like his. Well, some of these arguments are simply, pardon my French, bullshit. Let's count the ways. First, Zuckerberg tried to portray this whole issue as choices around free expression. That is ludicrous. This is not about limiting anyone's free speech. This is about giving people, including some of the most reprehensible people on Earth, the biggest platform in history to reach a third of the planet. Freedom of speech.
So? I said this in the muted video. It's like, Are we your children or something? Who the fuck is this guy? Who the fuck is this organization? It's like that. If you look at it psychologically, this is a person trying to fulfill the role of your parent. No joke. No, I'm not being hyperbolic at all. That is literally a parent-to-child relationship of, we know better than you, so we need to save you from yourself. So we need to regulate and get rid of all these ideas because you can't handle them. A third of the population, it could reach them. It's like, what? Are you my dad or something? What makes you... Who says you know better? I'm sure you don't know better. I'm sure he'd be... If he sat in a room with me for several hours and we talked things out, he might leave the room whimpering. But, oh, now I'm your daddy. Do you see how, like... Do you see what real maturity looks like? As opposed to... You know, just a parent that just says, no, 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 you can't do this, you can't do that. Kanye West, you can't jump on coffee tables. Stop expressing yourself. We all know the answers to this. Somehow the people with the most money and most attention seem to just get these things wrong all the time, right? You could just ask a dum-dum on the street. About, like, any topic. Hey, man. You know Jay-Z won against Nas, right? Like, fuck out of here. Nas won that shit. And they just get into an argument. And it's like, oh, okay. Some people, like, at certain points, you're going to have to concede. Certain points you're going to be right about. It's like, oh, okay. In a weird way, we're sort of making a better idea. Or maybe a better opinion. Based on just having a discussion about it. But daddy here wants to keep that away. And we all know what happens next, right? What happens when the parent says, no candy ever, and just keeps it from the kid and keeps it from the kid, and then the kid one day, you know, he's on a field trip and some kid sneaks him a piece of candy and he eats it. It's like, wah. Like, that kid's going to go apeshit eating candy. That doesn't always happen. I don't think it would always happen, but I'm just saying, as a story here, it's like, what do you think happens? So in this internet case, what happens when you start suppressing voices? People who really believe this shit and have no type of resistance to it. There's no resistance to it. The resistance is gone because you kick their ideas off the platform. They're off the platform. Thus, there's no outward resistance, you know, trying to knock down the idea. What do you think happens? It's always funny. They always pick out the people that are most likely to grab a gun. Like the people that are heavily focused on, like, my Second Amendment rights, my guns. It's like, what are you trying to start something? And from my cold, dead hands. But yeah, this guy's not your dad. If you understand that, like, okay, suppressing ideas does not make the world a better place. If you understand that, you are already more mature than him, and you are playing his daddy role. So all the shit he's going to have to eat for saying this, especially a guy who claims to be like a comedian or outside the box, or look at all the crazy shit I do. It's like, you're going to have to eat shit for this, because now they're your daddy or mom. I don't want to be, you know, sexist or anything. Well, let's continue, because I'm going to bring up my big picture psychological thing happening.
Which is not freedom of reach. Sadly, there will always be racists, misogynists, anti-Semites, and child abusers.
Semites.
But I think we can all agree that we should not be giving bigots and pedophiles a free platform to amplify their views and target their victims.
It's sort of like imagine like 20 years from now when people look back at this guy and like, wow, what a fucking idiot. And it's like, who gave him a platform to just let him spread his bullshit like this? I don't understand it. It's like, like fucking ironic, right? You can't let these bigots spread their ideas. They're just prowlers. They're on the prowl targeting kids. It's like, what the fuck are you doing, dude? When someone says something you don't like, you cover your eyes, your ears, you run away as fast as you can. Pretend it doesn't exist. And hopefully that kid won't shoot the school up one day. Hopefully. Just hope it happens. Don't worry. It won't reach me. I'm already a millionaire. I already isolate myself from the rest of the population. You guys will have to deal with it. Come on. This is so easy. Like, I should get paid for this. I should. Because of how easy it is. Yeah. All right, let's continue.
Second, Mark Zuckerberg claimed that new limits on what's posted on social media would be to pull back on free expression. This is utter nonsense. The First Amendment says that, and I quote, Congress shall make no law abridging freedom of speech. However, this does not apply to private businesses like Facebook. We're not asking these companies to determine the boundaries of free speech across society. We just want them to be responsible on their platforms. Now, if a neo-Nazi comes goose-stepping into a restaurant and starts threatening other customers and saying he wants to kill Jews, would the owner of the restaurant, a private business, be required to serve him an elegant 8-course meal? Of course not. The restaurant owner has every legal right, and indeed, I would argue, a moral obligation to kick that Nazi out. And so do these internet companies.
Remember when I just said, like, oh, that might have felt good to say out loud, but fuck, is that stupid? That is incredibly stupid. First of all, this guy does not, he stands on no moral high ground here at all. None. He has no moral high ground with this little speech thing here. So, since he brought up the word morality, let's bring some morality into it. Let's think about this real fast. There's a guy walking into a restaurant. He's like, he's being threatening and he's saying anti-Semitic stuff. And your answer to that is to say, get out of here. And go do it to the people outside. It's like go bother them out there. Stay away from my mansion. I mean, restaurant. But yeah, all right. Morally, what do you think you should do? Like, oh, okay. This guy's kind of, he said he's being threatening. Yeah, apparently he's into some bad ideas. Okay. All right, everyone. I'm closing the restaurant down. Can you all please leave the building? I'm kicking them out, by the way. And I say to the neo-Nazi guy, like, come sit down. You are going to get a fucking 8-course meal. And we're going to talk for hours if we can. Forever, however long I can have you sitting here without, you know, hurting anyone. Let's talk. Let's flesh out your ideas. Because the reason he's probably running around being threatening in the first place is because no one was listening to him. Right? He's probably not some guy who's like, I just gave a 4-hour lecture in front of Harvard, and they just didn't buy my ideas. I'm thinking I'm going to just go right to violence now. I'm going to start being violent because Harvard didn't understand my 4-hour lecture they let me have in front of them. It's like, no. Those guys are probably kicked out from one building to the next. And then, like, their last response is to be probably physically aggressive. And once again, this guy can say shit like that, and people at the ADL can say shit like that because it won't reach them. Right? Well, I hope it doesn't. All right, let's continue. That's right, give him a round of applause for that stupid fucking statement.
Now, third, Mark Zuckerberg seemed to equate regulation of companies like his to the actions of the most repressive societies. Incredible. This from one of the 6 people who decide what information so much of the world sees. Zuckerberg at Facebook, Sundar Pichai at Google, at its parent company, Alphabet, Larry Page and Sergey Brin, Brin's ex-sister-in-law, Susan Wojcicki at YouTube, and Jack Dorsey at Twitter, the Silicon Six. All billionaires, all Americans who care more about boosting their share price than about protecting democracy.
What? It's like, yeah, you're right. But the argument's on the other side. It's in favor of the other people, right? Like, they will censor people in order to make advertisement money. Who and what are they censoring? The people you're telling them to censor. You're just telling them to expand it further, essentially. It's like, you haven't gone far enough. You're fucking up democracy here. You're letting everyone have a voice. You're fucking up democracy. Do you hear the... Does that make any sense to anyone? So yeah, let me bring in the bigger psychological thing, the bigger picture, if you will. All right, let's say these six companies, or the Silicon Six and their companies, let's say they start censoring on behalf of the ADL and Sacha Baron Cohen, who's not funny, by the way. I'm just going to say, he's not funny. Wouldn't that just fill into the ideas that the guys that are kicking off, like the people that say, Jews run the world, they run Hollywood, they run all this shit. They run all the media things and all that shit. And then you give a big speech, this millionaire actor from Hollywood goes to the ADL and does a speech, which gets the six major social media platforms to change their policy to get rid of random guys talking about Jews running the world or whatever the fuck the idea is. It's like, doesn't that make them right, though? Like, you're just a random actor at a random conference, and somehow that shifted these filthy rich billionaires who have fuck you money, that shifted their policy in order to do what you wanted. Isn't that like just a self-fulfilling prophecy? How does someone take that psychologically? How do they look at that psychologically? They're like, well, fuck, that just happened. It's sort of like when I'm watching any of these politicians talk about Israel-Palestine, and they always say, of course Israel has the right to exist. It's like, hey, man, when you're talking about Saudi Arabia, you don't say that. When you're talking about these other countries, you never say, yeah, but Saudi Arabia has the right to exist. It's like, why do you say that? Who are you pandering to when you say that? So people, they're not stupid. They're looking at this and they're like, what is this? The America First guys, the Nick Fuentes, you know, E. Michael Jones, the Red Elephants guy, Black Pill dude. Those are random, like, YouTube guys I've seen. Those guys, they constantly ask, like, why do we give Israel $3.8 billion? What happened with the USS Liberty thing? Didn't they shoot down an American ship? And then they have, and of course, they had the informations on their side in that argument. So even though their end conclusion is to, we need to make America first and demographics and race and IQ and all the stupid ideas they come up with, even though that's their end conclusion, their evidence about when it comes to how America deals with Israel seems overwhelmingly like in their favor. It just turns out that way. And you're going to call them. Thus, they pick up more followers because they have better information than you do. Yeah, I watched the Nick Fuentes guy wreck, what's his name, Will Chamberlain. Not the basketball player, obviously. Although he looks like he's kind of tall, though. But yeah, white dude. He fucking wrecked his shit. Like, embarrassingly wrecked him. Like, the information, it's one-sided there. That's why I made a video about the alt-right would destroy these right-wing grifters on the internet. They would destroy them on foreign policy. They would destroy, like, a Ben Shapiro or one of these guys, or Crowder. Because it's not, the evidence is overwhelmingly one-sided. And this guy, who I don't know if he's paid to be here, if he really believes this, or he's just a robot, if he has another purpose in mind. I don't know what the point of this guy. I don't know why he's here, but the shit he's saying is so absurdly stupid. Just psychologically looking at it. I'm your daddy now, and you will not have these ideas around. It's like, what if that works, Sacha Baron Cohen? What if you, a Jewish actor who's a millionaire, from Hollywood, goes to the ADL, complains about whatever alt-right people on the internet, and then you get them censored and banned. You're just proving their fucking point. So this is, once again, silly, self-fulfilling prophecy bullshit. This should be so obvious. If you pay attention to a little bit of psychology, just looking at this scenario, what do you think is going to come about from this? So, all right. This is my watered-down version. I think my other one was better, but my mic was off the whole time. I'm so embarrassed, oh God. So, all right. That's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you feel like, comment, agree, disagree, send me information. Hey, put a link down. Tell me what you think. Tell me something I don't know about or whatever. Don't be shy. Donate. Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. And with all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you wanna get him.